I want to teach you a mnemonic device for constructing a molecular orbital diagram of a cyclic polyene. If that cyclic polyene contains n atoms, we use a polygon that has n vertices and n sides. So for example, a 3-atom system, we'll use a triangle. For a 4-atom system, we'll use a square, etc. What we want to do is take that polygon and place it with one vertex down. So in each of these, you can see that we've positioned a vertex at the very bottom. Next, we're going to inscribe a circle around that polygon. Everywhere that that circle intersects the polygon, we'll place an energy level. And so we always will have one energy level at the bottom where we positioned that first vertex. And then every other position that intersects, we'll place a pair of levels if there are two intersection points, etc. And in the case of the even-membered polygons, we'll have a position at the very top. The only other thing I need to tell you is that this line that cuts through the middle of the circle, the semicircle or hemisphere line, represents the energy level of an atomic p orbital. And so any electrons that occupy positions and energy below that line will contribute toward bonding interactions. Any electrons at that level will be non-bonding, and any electrons above that line will be anti-bonding. And now we can use those rules in order to look at a system like this, cyclopropane cation. The cyclopropane cation has 2 pi electrons. We would just put 2 electrons below that atomic p level energy, and we would have a favorable interaction. So 2 pi electrons in a 3-membered ring, that's a favorable system for aromaticity, and it matches Hund's rule, 4n plus 2, where n is equal to 0. What about in the case of the cyclobutadiene? In the case of cyclobutadiene, we have 4 pi electrons, and so you can see we're going to use the square, but in that case now we have to use Hund's rule, adding those last 2 electrons with spin aligned, and they're at the non-bonding energy level. The 4 pi electron system is not favorable, it's anti-aromatic. In the case of the 4 pi cyclopentadiene cation also is a 4 pi system, and so the last 2 electrons would fill that position. Although they're below the energy level of the atomic p orbital, they're not going to be bonding, and so that's not favorable as well. However, the cyclopentadiene anion is a 6 pi electron system, and so in that case we'll fill all 3 of those levels, and we have all 3 position below the p atomic orbital energy level, and so that's favorable. That is an aromatic system. We know benzene it matches the 4n plus 2 rule. Both of these do, 4n plus 2, where n is equal to 1, and we have aromatic systems in both cases. In the case of cycloheptatriene cation has 6 pi electrons in it, and so we use the heptagon, and we see that there are all 3 levels below the p orbital level are filled and contribute toward bonding, and so we have an aromatic system in that case. This polygon here, you might want to draw this structure in your notes. It would be the cyclooctatetraene system, and the cyclooctatetraene system is going to look like a stop sign. It's going to look like a stop sign with a double bond in every other position, and there's going to be a total of 8 pi electrons in that case, and so that 8 pi electron system is going to be anti-aromatic, since two levels are going to be singly occupied at the non-bonding energy level, and that is anti-aromatic. So the mnemonic device quickly explains Hund's rule. The vertex at the bottom is going to have 2 electrons. So in the 4n plus 2 Hund's rule, we see that the plus 2 comes from the pair of electrons that will always be positioned at the bottom. And then there'll be pairs of degenerate levels above that, and they'll each have 4 electrons. So for as many number of degenerate levels as we have, there'll be 4, and there'll be n of them in degenerate levels, and so we can see where Hund's rule comes from using this mnemonic device.